In this video, I'm going to show you a quick, easy way to add or subtract two fractions. So let's take in general two fractions, a over b plus c over d. Notice this is just two fractions and they are not mixed numbers. Alright, so to see what this is going to equal, first I'm just going to write it like this and say, how would I get the least common denominator? By picking what the making sure I get a common denominator. Well, if I use the jealousy method or prime factorization method, I see that in the denominator here, I have a b. I also need a d to have one of the factors of the second fraction. So this will be a times d. And that means the least common denominator is bd. So I also need a b over in my second fraction in the denominator. So I multiply my second fraction by b over b. And now I have a common denominator of bd. So in the numerator, I have ad plus bc. All right, so that's the quick and easy way to do it. Ad plus bc over bd. Now, why is that easy to remember? Well, basically, the new denominator, you just multiply the two denominators together, b times d. You look at the diagonals of your original fractions, a times d, and add it to the other diagonal when you multiply them together, plus bc. So let's look at an example. Let's say you had 3/8 plus 1/5. The new denominator, you simply multiply the two denominators together, which is 40ths. And after I do that, I just put the plus sign up on top because I remember I'm going to add the product of each diagonal. So on the first diagonal, I have 3 times 5, which is 15. And in the second diagonal, I have 8 times 1, which is 8. And so my answer is 23/40. Now, depending on the problem, you might have to reduce or you might change it to a mixed number. So let's do another problem. How about 5/12 plus 3, let's say, 11ths. All right, so the denominator we multiply together, 12 times 11, which is 132, and then I write a plus above that. So I on one diagonal, I multiply 5 times 11 is 55, and along the other diagonal, 12 times 3 is 36. So now I add those together, and I have 91 over 132. Now, you want to make sure that this cannot be reduced. So if you did prime factor 91, it's 7 times 13, and 7 does not go into 132, and neither does 13. So this is the reduced answer. What if you were subtracting two fractions? Like a over b minus c over d. The only difference is that up above here, it's going to be a subtraction. So remember when you do the diagonal, you have to start out with the very first number. As you're writing from left to right, it's a times d first. It does matter that that goes before the minus sign. So here's an example, 8/9 minus 3/7. All right, so first we begin by multiplying the denominators together. 9 times 7 is 63. And since it's a subtraction problem, we put a minus sign above it. So you have 8 times 7 is 56 minus 9 times 3 is 27. And then we have to subtract. So we get 29 over 63. That's reduced since 29 is prime and doesn't go into 63. So there's our answer. So hopefully you're getting the hang of it, and yes, this always works. But sometimes it is easier to get the least common denominator instead. So let's do this problem. 3, 6, I'm sorry, no, let's not do 3, 6. 3 eighths plus, say, 1 sixth. Right, if we use this method, we multiply the denominators together, which is 48. Put the plus sign on top since it's a plus. So we do the diagonals. 3 times 6 is 18. And 8 times 1 is 8. And so when I add the numerators, I get 26 48ths. This is not reduced. So then we have to reduce, dividing top and bottom by 2, we get 13 24ths. Now here's the key. If you look at the denominators, the original denominators, 8 and 6, there's a common factor of 2, which means the least common denominator is not going to be 8 times 6. So if the greatest common factor is 2, in the end you'll have to divide the top and bottom by that number that was the greatest common factor. So you could have done this problem the other way, where you get a common denominator of, well, do you know what the least common denominator is between 8 and 6? There's a lot of ways I've shown how to get the least common denominator. It's 24ths. So I'm not going to go over how I got that for the moment, but that's the smallest number they both divide into evenly. So I would have to multiply the first fraction, 3 eighths, by 3 over 3, and that would give you 9 for the numerator. And the second fraction, 1 sixth, I'd have to multiply top and bottom by 4 over 4. So I'd have 4. And just notice I would still get 13 24ths. So if you would have gotten the least common denominator, then at the end you won't have to reduce necessarily. Once in a while you might have to reduce, but in this case you would not have to reduce. So here's another example. Let's keep in mind the rule AD plus BC over BD. And let's say we had 5 twelfths plus 7 eighteenths. This method is definitely going to work, but you're going to have to work with much larger numbers if you use it, because you have to do 12 times 18, you're going to have to do the 5 times 18, the 12 times 7, etc. This would be easier to get a common denominator of 36 and add by multiplying the first fraction by 3 over 3, the second fraction by 2 over 2. So the answer will be 29/36. But this method does work. So let's do it and see that we would get the same answer. So we have to do 12 times 18, which is 216. That's addition, so I put a plus. I have to do 5 times 18, which is 90. And I have to do 12 times 7, which is 84. And then I have to add 90 plus 84, and that's 174 over 216. But that's not reduced. You could tell right away it's not reduced because it has two even numbers. So if you reduced 174 over 216, you should get 29/36. Now, if you look at your original problem, you see there's a common factor of 6. The hint is that's what you'll be able to divide the top and bottom by. So if you pay attention to the greatest common factor being 6, you could divide top and bottom by 6, and you'll get 29 over 36. Or you could simply just start reducing. Like, hopefully you realize you could divide top and bottom by 2, so you could start off with that, which is 87 over 108. And then that may look to you like it's reduced, but it's not, because 3 goes into both of those numbers. Remember, the divisibility test for 3 is add the digits, and if you add the digits, you get a number 3 goes into. So you could also divide both the numerator and denominator by 3, and you'll get 29/36. So using this method is not so great when you have a common factor in the denominators. It's easier to just go ahead and use the least common denominator like that. so that you don't have all this reducing at the end in very large numbers. But it does always work. So if you want to remember it and always use it, and then just be very careful about reducing at the end if necessary, you've got a new method.